Hello, dear students. I am Dr. Mazhar Ali, and I welcome you to course Introduction to Artificial Intelligence. It's my third lecture on Introduction to Artificial Intelligence. This lecture is a part of my previous lecture, which was on the intelligent agents. So, in the first part, I was discussed the importance of importance and significance of the intelligent agents, how they work. And what is their architecture, and what type of the hardware and software is required to develop the intelligent agents? What is the programming? What is program, and what is the function, and how the agent may be developed is the rational that can understand the environment and work accordingly. So such type of the topics were discussed in first part. In second part, means in today's lecture, I will discuss various types of intelligent agents and their functionality, that how they perceive the percepts from environment and work accordingly, means how they learn from the environment, how they get training from the environment, and then returns the actions accordingly. So in this lecture, we'll discuss the various types of the artificial intelligence agents. Intelligent agents can be any entity or object like human beings. So these agents are capable of making decisions based on the inputs they receive from the environment using the sensors and aids on the environment using the actuators. So artificial intelligence enabled agents collect input from the environment by making use of sensors like cameras, microphones, or other sensing devices. The agents perform some real-time computation on the input and deliver output using actuators. These agents have abilities like real-time problem solving, error and success rate analysis, and information retrieval. Intelligent agents can come in any of the hardware or software categories, such as the robotic agents, which is a hardware-based agent, and the software agent, which is the software-based agents. Both agents are working in different ways. However, their working style or their programming may be same, but their working style is different as per environment. Hardware is a definitely hardware agent will show itself as a physical agent or the hardware based agent, since the software agent is the virtual agent whom we cannot touch, but we can see its performance. So the intelligent agents are developed based on the development of the human agent. A human agent uses eyes, nose, tongue, and other sensory organs as sensors to perceive information from the environment, and uses limbs and a vocal tract or the tongue, other legs, arms, hands, foot, and etc. as an actuator to perform an action based on the information. Because intelligent agents are developed on the basis of development of a human. How human getting development in any environment, same concept is taken to develop the intelligent agents. We, the humans, learn from the environment, in which environment we are living, in which we perform, we act accordingly. So that's why humans all over the world show their presence, perform their actions according to their related environments. Though humans are by shape are same, but their by actions are different, because they learn from the environment. Same agents for any environment are developed. So agent will give a response or return the action as per environment for which agents have been developed. So if the hardware-based agents are presented in shape of robots. So the robots or the robotic agents uses cameras and infrared radar as the sensors to record information from the environment, and it uses reflex motors as actuators to deliver output back to the environment. Because a robot is a physical shape agent, physical shaped agent, which walk and perform any action through their arms and legs. So to activate the legs and arms and other parts, body parts of the robot, motors are embedded inside the robot that activate all parts of the robotic agent. However, software agent uses keypad strokes or keyboards, audio commands as input sensors, means in software-based agent input the data through keyboard or mouse or mic or other input devices, and it shows the output in form of screens or display unit as actuator. So these agents are classified into these five types on basis of their capability, range, and extent of intelligence. So for example, the first one is a simple reflex agent, and the second one is a model based reflex agent, which is the upgraded version of simple reflex agent, and the third one is a core based agent, fourth one is a utility based agent, and the fifth one is a learning based agent. So I will discuss all these five types of intelligent agents with you in coming slides. Simple reflex agent. This agent is the basic form of agents and function, and it function only in the current state. Means what is the current position, what it perceived currently from the environment, it performs action accordingly. So this type of the agents have very low intelligence capability, as they cannot store past states. So these types of agents respond to event based on predefined rules, which are pre-programmed. They perform well only when the environment is fully observable. So these agents are helpful only on a limited number of cases, something like a smart thermostat. Simple reflex agent hold a static table from where they fetch all the predefined rules for performing an action. So their actions are based on the current percept. They only looks at the current state and decides what to do. Neither they hold nor consider any part of the history during their decision process. Because simple reflex agent does not store the percepts in the memory. Therefore, it cannot maintain the percept history. So it's it works only on the current inputs. What it inputs, it gives the output or perform the actions. It does not store any input in the memory or output in the memory. In some cases, like smart thermostat, this type of agent might be useful. However, in most cases, it is not useful. Especially if the environment is partially observable, it might be the recipe of a disaster. As I said, they have very limited intelligence. Their intelligence is only based on the given static table. So there's no concept of learning capacity in simple reflex agents. So a simple reflex agent holds a static table for rules only, because what it take from the environment, it match with the table where the rules are available, and then perform the action. So it gets a percept as an input from the environment, and then in the static table finds the corresponding rule to this state, means which rule matches with this state or percept. So then in the static table, after finding the corresponding rule, then it returns the action, means at least at last returns the action of the rule as per the requirement of the environment. So the rules are like the form of if and then, means the rules are consisted of if and then conditions. So that's why if a rule matches with the state, then it performs the action, otherwise not. So if you look here at this state function, the state is a means interpret input, percept, what it is percepting from the perceiving from the environment, means it perceives the percepts from the environment, then it try to interpret this percept, that what is inputting, what is instruction to do something. Then after interpreting this percept, it matches with the rule. If rule is matched, then it returns the action, means it performs the actions. So what is said to it? For example, environment is give instructions to agent to do this job, then this agent interpret that order or instruction and match with the rules, and then according to rule it perform the action. Another type of the model agent is a model-based reflex agent. So it is an upgraded version of the simple reflex agent. It is an advanced version even of the simple reflex agent, like simple reflex agent does not store the memory, but it stores the memory. Therefore, it can also, the model-based reflex agent respond to event based on the predefined conditions. On top of that, it also can store the internal state, means past information. What it perceives from the environment, it matches with the rules or and even the previous data that is available in the percept history. So means it take decision based on the previous events or the data available in the percept history. So model based agents updates the internal state at each step. These internal states aid agents in handling the observable environment. In order to perform any action, it relies on both internal state and current percept. However, it is almost next to impossible to find the exact state when dealing with an observable environment. So this type of agent is a little bit more complicated than the reflex-based agent. A model-based agent holds an internal state based on the percept history. This internal state helps the agent to handle a partially observable environment. It considers both internal state and current percept to take action. Also, each step updates the internal state. So updating the internal state required two kinds of the knowledge. The first kind is the agent needs to know how the word evolves independently from the agent. And the second knowledge is how the agent's action affect the environment. Means what action will return the value, how it affect the environment. So both kind of knowledge are embedded in the agent's program, and they help the agent to understand how the world works. Implementation of this model is called the model of the world, and the agent that uses this model to decide what action to take is called a model-based agent. So a model-based reflex agent takes the current percept and combines it with the internal state. So our internal state or model and most recent action effect then decide about what action to take. So this agent has to keep track of an internal state or the percept history. So it depends on the percept history, means any order or instruction it gets or any obstacle even it faces. So it follow the percept history, then it take some decision. For example, a driving car, how it changes the lane if it faces the any obstacle. So what it would do? So definitely driving car, I mean the automatic driving car or intelligent based driving car, if it faces the any obstacle, then it will decide. How it will decide? It will decide on the basis of perceived history. Means it will go to the previous data in which such type of the problems are discussed and rules are available. If driving car face any obstacle, then it should change the lane either on the right side or on the left side as per the way. So all the instructions are available in the rules table, and the history of solving the problems is available in the percept history. So if you look here, state is definitely, what is the state? For example, a driving car has faced the any obstacle, then it would update the state that it is facing some obstacle. Because this percept is perceived from the environment, and then the driving car will match the rule, means state rule, how a driving car may be saved from the obstacle. And if a rule is matched, then action will be taken, means the lane will be changed, and then state will be updated again with the current that the car is going smoothly. For example, if you look here, these are the rules, these are the rule condition condition based table. So if driving car saw an object ahead and then turned right and it's now clear ahead, then go straight, because there's no obstacle, it should go straight. But if a driving car saw an object ahead and turn and right to save itself from the obstacle, but again it faced object ahead on the right side path, so what driving car should do? So again the car will be halt and go to the rules table or the percept history to solve the problem. But if driving car does not see object on the path or object ahead, then it will go straight. But if it see object ahead, then turn randomly as per these rules. Another type of the agents is a goal-based agent. The action taken by these agents depends on the distance from their goal. Goal means the desired situation. The actions are intended to reduce the distance between the current state and the desired state. Current state means where it is, and desired state means the goal where it is to reach. For example, a car. Now, car current state is on the way, but the distance target is ahead. So, in order to attain its goal, it makes use of search and planning algorithm. Means if any obstacle or even obstacle comes, or if there are two ways to reach the goal, what this agent should do. So it will use the algorithm that is called the search and planning. So one drawback of goal-based agent is that they do not always select the most optimized path to reach the final goal. So definitely it happens sometimes. If there are two or more than two solutions, then what should do? What algorithm should do? So sometimes it does not perform very well. So for some tasks, it is not always enough to know how the world works. In some cases, it is desirable to define goal information to describe a desirable situation. So a goal-based agent combines a model-based agent's model with a goal. To reach its goal, it often uses search and planning algorithm. So the model-based agent algorithm may make this agent more powerful and sensible as well. because the current state of environment is always not enough, because the target or the goal is ahead. Therefore, current state is not enough. Therefore, goal is another issue to achieve, because agent or anyone does not know that what will be ahead in coming path. So judgment of rationality or correctness definitely helps. If the agent is rational, then it reach the goal easily. Because again, if you look at the problem of driving car, or even you have to reach any place or target, and you do have 3 to 5 path, what will you do? So you have to search that which path is suitable to reach the target, and accordingly you will plan to reach the target. So goal-based agents are less efficient in this sense, but more flexible, because there are different tasks or different goals for the agents which agent has to finish. Therefore, it searches, and in searches maybe there may be problems, and it plans according to searches. That's why it's less efficient, but flexible too much, because it search different dimensions or aspects to solve the problem. Another type of the intelligent agents is a utility-based agent. The action taken by utility agent depend on the end objective. So they are called utility agent, because now what is the end, the final object? That will be the utility agent. So utility agents are used when there are multiple solutions to a problem, and the best possible alternative has to be chosen. The alternative chosen is based on each state's utility. They perform a cost-benefit analysis of each solution and select the one which can achieve the goal in minimum cost. With the utility-based agents, we use the utility function, which is essentially an internalization of the performance. Also, if there are multiple goals and these goals conflict in some cases, the utility function specifies the appropriate trade-off. Also, if none of these goals can be achieved with the certainty, the utility may provide the likelihood of success. So, technically speaking, a rational utility-based agent chooses its action to maximize the performance, because utility agent generate the high-quality behavior to reach the target. For example, there are meals in a canteen. Now, is it good or not? Is it fresh or not? How would you decide? So an agent decide this viewing the different solutions and dimensions, and definitely there may be several solutions which prove that meal is fresh and good and tasty. But you have to, our agent has to select only one solution which is the best than all, and that will make it the utility agent or utility based agent. Means the best solution is selected by an agent is called utility based agent. Keep in mind, the goal of the utility agent is when it achieves the goal, means it's successful. So it shows the accuracy of the working of the utility based agent. There are several advantages of the utility based agents than the others. For example, when there are conflicting goals, because of there are always conflicting goals. Why? Because there are always more than one solution. So if there is a more than one solution, then an agent has to think, means agent has to be rational to select the best one, means best solution. So only some are the goals, but not all can be achieved. If there are five goals, only one or two goals may be the best, but not all. And even the agent cannot achieve all the goals, but it is to achieve one or two goals. So utility describes the appropriate trade-off. Another advantages of this agent is when there are several goals. So none of them are achieved certainly. Because there are several goals and one cannot achieve all the goals at a time. So utility provides a way for the decision making on basis of its rationalism, that how these goals may be achieved. So this is a beauty and performance of the utility based agents that achieve the goals with the best solutions. Another type of the agents is the learning based agents or learning agents. So learning agents have learning abilities, so they can learn from their experiences or learn from the environment. These types of agents can start from scratch and over time can acquire significant knowledge from their environment. Same as we humans learn from the environment, learn from home, learn from internal environment, learn from external environment. We learn from schools, colleges, universities. We learn from friends. We learn from offices and so on. Same such type of the agents are learning from different environments to improve their quality, to improve their performance. We may improve our performance by learning and experiencing. So these type of learning agents experiencing from the environment where they are working. So after an agent is programmed, no agent can work immediately, but they need training or teaching that how to work in this environment, how to perform its job in this environment. Like when we appoint any human in the environment, we give training to that human to work in the environment. Same happens with the agents. When agent is deployed in an environment, it needs some trainings and teachings. So in artificial intelligence, once an agent is done, we teach or train it by giving it a set of examples and instructions or rules, and then test it by using another set of examples that either this agent is working properly or not. So the best accuracy or high accuracy show the better performance of agents. The learning agents have four major components which enable it to learn from its experience. So learning elements. Now learning element means it takes input from the critic and helps agent in the performance improvement by learning from the environment. Now what is critic? The critic evaluates how well the agent is performing. Means it tells the learning element how well the agent is doing with the respect to fixed performance standard. And definitely this will make improvement and make the performance of agent good. And then the performance element. So performance element is a component. It is a component that decides on the actions to be taken to improve the performance. And how these elements will be tested or evaluated. So problem generator, a problem is generated to evaluate the performance of the agent, that either it's working properly or not. So problem generator takes input from the other components and suggests actions which will result in a better experience. If the agent is working properly on that problem, definitely then the result will be better. And no doubt there will be the experience of the agent. So these are the problems are basically suggest some actions. When a problem is generated, then it is suggested or suggest some actions that will lead to new and informative experience, which make the agent more experienced. Means this they will improve the performance of learning agent. So the end goal of any agent, means what we discussed, the five agents, the end goal of any agent is to perform task that otherwise have to be performed by humans. So agents act like an intelligent assistant or intelligent agent, which can enable automation of repetitive task, help in the data summarization, learn from the environment, and make recommendations for the right course of action, which will help in reaching the goal state. Intelligent agents are in immune use today, and its usage will only expand in the future. The automation system is working on based on the intelligent agents. That may be the automatic car, automatic machine, automatic doors, and different things are automated nowadays. And these are because of the intelligent agents. That may be the software-based intelligent agent or hardware-based intelligent agents. Even now, robots are used for the security of different types of the personalities, organizations, and so on. And they are working well. So in the future, even this current modern era is of artificial intelligence, and intelligent agents are performing very well in the artificial intelligence. These are the structure of the learning agents. I discussed these all: critic, learning elements, performance elements, that how performance elements are working. The performance elements are working on based on learning elements and problem generator, which make the performance proper. And the results are given through the actuators. So, I have assignment for you from these two lectures on the intelligent agents, means part one and part two. If you are new to this lecture, then first watch the part one of this lecture. I put the link of that lecture in the description area. You may open that link and watch that, and then watch this. You can understand the functionality and working of intelligent agents and various type of intelligent agents properly, and then you can do this assignment. So you have to do this assignment. In this assignment, you have to define the P's, means performance, environment, actuators, and sensors description for the following task. There are three tasks for you: robot saucer player. You have to describe robot saucer player according to these four elements, and then shopping of artificial intelligence books on the internet, because there are also intelligent agents. So you have to define this process through these four elements, and then analyze the properties of the above environment. What you discussed in these, what you described the environment for these two tasks, then analyze the properties of this environment. So this is our environment. Hope you will do, and send me. Thank you very much for watching this lecture on the various types of the intelligent agents. Hope you got it a lot and understand the functionality and the working of the various types of the intelligent agents. And I have assigned an assignment to you. Hope you will finish that assignment as well. We will meet with the new topic of introduction to artificial intelligence in coming week. Till you finish your assignment, and take care of you. Stay blessed.